Hello, welcome to another episode of Everyday Life with Ralph Powers Jr., which is me. I might change the title a little bit, sounds too girly. But, welcome to another episode of mine. I'm right here in my kitchen right now, and I'm about to have me some cake. It's nobody's birthday at all, but I wanted this cake. And having a difficult time trying to open this thing. While I try to open up this cake thing, take a look at some of these videos of mine. I love food. And I'm going to share some clips of some foods I've enjoyed. Enjoy. Bacon, man. I hope you enjoyed those clips I showed you. I'm still having a difficult time trying to get this thing open. I have been on YouTube for a while. I haven't been downloading my videos for almost a week now. So what I'm going to do now is show you some clips I have been shooting. See, even though I'm not on YouTube, I haven't been downloading stuff on YouTube, I'm still making videos. Today is Saturday, February 8th, 2014. It is 2:46 p.m.
As she continues to love the career that she's had for 28 years.
Thank you.
That is good. That is good. Today is Monday, February 10th, 2014. It is 7:46 a.m. And oh boy. My bedroom is a mess. Old dishes. Soda cans. Clothing, the PlayStation 2 I don't play anymore. This room is a mess. Soda bottle, clothing, food. It is 7:46 a.m. right now, and the next clip you see, my room will be clean. All I have to do now is just vacuum. No more dust. No more PlayStation 2. It's going back to my sister. She let me borrow it for quite some time. I don't play it anymore, so I'm going to give it back. My room is clean. I'm going to do it. I did it. Hooray for me. Now I can enjoy some of this delicious cake. Cake dust. Well, here it is, a birthday cake, yet it's not my birthday or anybody else's birthday. I just wanted this because I was hungry and I wanted a cake just like this. Oh yeah, some bacon, man. I have some cake, and I have bacon, man. Cake, bacon.
Today is Sunday, February 9th, 2014, is 1:33 a.m.
Case came at a time when our homicides were very, very low. And obviously, those take the most investigatory time.
Relatively quiet nights on Milwaukee streets translated into more detectives, officers, and others devoting resources to finding the Stradivarius violin.
The amount of time we put into it, given the fact it's basically a $6 million robbery, was not out of the ordinary for what one would do for a case of that magnitude.
Flynn says the whole ordeal has created a unique bond between the Milwaukee Symphony Orchestra and the police department.
Maybe we can take them to the firing range and they can take us to the concert hall.
Allman will take the stage for the first time with the recovered Lipinski Stradivarius on Monday in Brookfield, and it seems at least one new fan will soon be in the audience.
I'll go see it when he's in Milwaukee. And when that violin comes home, and home is Milwaukee, I'll go see it.
Now, I asked the chief what song he'd like to hear Frank Allman play when he's in Milwaukee next, and the chief said after the last few weeks that he has had just about any song would be music to his ears. Live in downtown Milwaukee, Brett LeMoyne, Fox 6 News.
Did he say anything about a big steak dinner tonight or maybe just some sleep?
Yeah, I think that's probably in the cards, Ben.
All right, thanks, Brett. Appreciate it. You can find more on this story plus our earlier stories on the violin at fox6now.com.
The cold weather claims another life. Yesterday, a 94-year-old woman died from complications of hypothermia. And believe it or not, it's actually not always easy to tell when someone is in trouble. Fox 6's Brandon Cruz at 5 tonight with more on that is live in Milwaukee. Brandon.
Yeah, that woman was found lying on the floor with the heat turned off in her home. Her core temperature was only 77 degrees when a family member came by the house to deliver food. Well, there are many ways to try to ensure the safety of the elderly who are in need during this time of very cold weather.
We help him with his meals. We help him when he does need some bathing assistance.
Oh, yeah. Good job.
For the last 4 years, Salvatore has been giving assistance from Synergy Home Care to help with a variety of needs.
He's been able to stay in his own home and be very happy and satisfied.
It's got to be a blue card, Sal. You got any blue?
His caregiver, Kayla, makes sure he eats and is safe while also socializing with him throughout the day.
You beat me already.
We work really hard at that, making sure that the people who are in this home are the right fit, personality-wise, and have the right skill sets.
Ruth Busolaki is the president and owner of Synergy and says even if seniors say they don't need assistance, it's important to check on them anyway, especially when the weather is extremely cold.
That face-to-face is a really critical piece of keeping our seniors safe.
On Thursday, a 94-year-old woman was found dead in her home when a family member was bringing her food. The heat in her home was off and her body temperature had fallen to 77 degrees.
That's a tragic situation, and you know, families do their very best to try to...
Subaru.
Love. It's what makes a Subaru.
Subaru.
A Subaru. Bring the truck and the trailer. It's time to stock up.
Subaru.
Stock your closet.
Subaru.
Jeans and ladies' Lee jeans. All $3 off. Keep your motor running with Mobile One synthetic motor oil. Just $5.99 a quart. Your ultra best friend deserves Sprout Ultra Dog Food. All 35 pound bags are $21.99. Westonian Painter's Cut Spray Paint is on sale. Three for $7.98. It's the stock up sale at Mills Fleet Farm.
Sunburst Winter Sports Park for skiing, snowboarding, and snow tubing. Sunburst is now the largest snow tubing complex in North America. Check us out at skisunburst.com.
Some students find a traditional education too limiting. EHE Academy is a tuition-free online school option for grades 6 and 12.
Thank you.
manager of the Wilson Center on the Yard in Brookfield. For Frank Long, this is scheduled for the 4th Monday night.
Here we go. agent.
Should do that instead. 11 violations last week and a $107 fine after the health inspector found all kinds of problems in the kitchen. Two food soiled socks were found hanging on a rack by cooking equipment. General filth was everywhere on food storage containers, strainer baskets, and utensils. Some containers had mold buildup.
No manager here? Would you be able to give this to the manager and have him give me a call back, please?
The staff at Beijing Express wanted nothing to do with us, refusing to even look at the latest health inspection.
Did you get the socks out of the kitchen hanging over the pots?
Keeping it clean this week is Buckley's on Milwaukee's east side, featured once before as a blue ribbon winner. On their visit last week, health inspectors found the kitchen to be spotless.
Well, we know you go to these restaurants all the time. If you see one that does not look right, let us know at TMJ4.com. You ask, we investigate.
And we've got much more coming up,
including a Winter Olympic update.
But first, let's take a look at what's on TV tonight. It all starts at 6:30 with NBC's coverage of the Olympics opening ceremony. After that, join us back here live at 10.
New at 10, a hot-button issue that affects almost everyone. Talked about, though, by almost nobody. A classroom controversy has people fired up and fearing for their children's futures. Parents, this is one report you don't want to miss tonight after the opening ceremony. Right here on today's TMJ4.
A semi ran me off the road and I got seriously hurt. But then a good friend of mine told me to call Google Law. They got me $295,000. One call, that's all.
You have to take this back.
You want the floor fantasy?
I only have this watch. I never saw how it looked.
At Lazy Boy, you don't have to worry about the fabric, letters, and options of stuff because you can see it before you order it.
Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries. Live life comfortably.
Fifth grade was a struggle. I mean, it was hard for him.
The teachers didn't really understand what was happening with me.
I mean, he was very stressed out.
At K-12, we think every child deserves the best chance to succeed in school. Now there's a tuition-free choice for kindergarten through 12th graders, an online public school powered by K-12. K-12 offers flexible schedules and programs customized for each student. The award-winning curriculum is taught by highly qualified teachers. Textbooks, videos, and materials are all included free. To find out more, call or click today.
That student has no way to fall through those cracks at all because the parent and the teacher are working so hard together that they're going to succeed.
Since starting online school and being home, his whole demeanor has changed.
Don't wait. Make a choice that can change the course of your child's life. For your free information kit, call or visit k12.com today.
This month, GMC is going to work for you using new ideas.
ideas and incredible thinking to bring you a professional-grade lineup of advanced engineering and higher standards. And with 2 years of scheduled maintenance on the entire GMC lineup, February is a great time for you to step up to a new GMC. Just announced through February 28th. Use your President's Day.